Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video will show you how to smooth out a bumpy camera move with Jitter. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. When intentionally moving a camera, with or without support, sometimes we introduce unwanted bumpy movements. Now you want the camera move, but not the bumps. So you still use the stabilizer. However, you also use jitter removal to analyze the stabilized curve and extract out the bumps. We will achieve this using the 2D transform node as part of our workflow. Please note that these techniques can also be applied using the axis timeline effects and the Action 3D compositor. Workflows with those tools are covered in other videos. Here we have a shot of a London street involving a pan and tilt move. There are some unwanted movements, especially at the end of the camera move. To remove them with the 2D transform node, we go into Connect Effects. Press Ctrl Tab to bring up the effects ribbon. Click Create Connect Effects. In the Connect Effects node bin, drag out the 2D transform node. Drop the node into the connection after the source media node. Double-click on the node to bring up its controls. Now the 2D transform node comprises of a series of tabs for different functions. Click on the stabilization tab. Click the LED to enable the tool. The stabilization interface looks different from what you have seen in the axis timeline effects and action menus. However, it's pretty straightforward and easy to work with. But the first thing with all stabilization is to track the image. Click the Enter Stabilizer button. Go to frame 1 and fit the image to the viewer window. Press 1 to select the first tracker. Click and move the tracker boxes over the middle alarm box. Now press 2 and select the second tracker. Click and drag the tracker boxes over the right alarm box. Now click the Analyze button to begin the track. Once this is done, press Return to go back to the 2D transform menus. Scrubbing the time bar, you will see that the stabilization has stabilized the entire image. For static shots, this is fine, but for panning shots, this looks incorrect. So we have stabilized all the movements instead of just the bumps. You'll notice that the stabilizer is on for X and Y position. If you want to just stabilize the vertical movement, for example, you would disable the X position. Scrubbing the time bar, you can see that the horizontal pan is restored, but the vertical is stabilized. This is fine for horizontal pans, but not this type of camera move. There is also a rotation move that I would like to smooth out. Turn on rotation. So you can choose what you want to stabilize through this menu. Turn X position back on. We are going to dig even deeper into the stabilized data. Let's have a look at the animation curve for stabilization. Click the animation button to go to the animation editor. Expand the Transform 2D Channels, Stabilization, and finally Position. Hold Command and select the Position Channels and the Rotation Channel. Press Frame to fit the selected white curves to the window. To the right of the animation window, you will find the Curve Functions pulldown. Click the pulldown and set the function to Jitter. Nothing will happen because you have to enter in an average value next to the jitter option. This value will be mathematically applied to the stabilized animation curve. The resulting new curve will only contain jitter values as keyframes that are ultimately stabilized. I'll enter in a value of 100. The higher the value, the more stabilization is applied. Since every motion is different, this is a case of trial and error until you get the value you want. press Command Z to undo the operation if you wish to try again. Let's fit the new curves to the window with the frame button. The curves look very different. The way to read the jitter curve is that everything at zero will not be stabilized. Anything above or below zero will have stabilization applied, and the height of the curve will determine the strength of the stabilization. Now scrubbing the time bar, you can see that the camera move is back again. You will also note that the stabilization on the move causes the usual black edges. Let's fix that. Click the animation button to return to the 2D transform menus. You could click the axis transform tab and manually scale the frame bigger to hide the edges. However, going back to the stabilization tab, you will find a header called framing. It is currently set to shift. Switch it to crop edges. Smoke has automatically cropped out all the black edges for you. Scrubbing the time bar, you can see the applied stabilization. There is one more thing I want to look at. If you scrub to the last frame, you will see that the lamppost is not straight because of the stabilization. You will see the reference frame is set to frame 1. This means that frame 1 is the basis of the stabilization. All the other frames are stabilized using that reference. If I click Set Frame, the last frame now becomes the reference point for the stabilization. So this frame is the original unstabilized frame, and everything else around it is stabilized. This can be very useful if you have found a frame in the middle of your clip that you want to use as your reference. More about this in the next video. For image processing, set the filtering to linear and turn on the anti-aliasing button. Exit ConnectFX and press the render button. Once the render is complete, we can play the clip in the full screen player. Let's move on to the next example where we will stabilize a background plate for compositing. We will then composite an element and finish off by destabilizing the composite to add the camera move back into the image. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.